Hello, world.
Ainsley, Chris, Lindsay, Jackie, there's everybody's here. Will, Charlie, Dennis, Sandra, Ryder, Roger, Jamie, Lauren, Jack, and then who are we missing?
Your daughter.
Yeah, and we're missing the most. K Casey. So here's to you, Casey. Yeah.
Here's to you, Casey. Cheers.
And we found a new place this year.
Yep.
And,
yes.
You would like it.
Yep.
So.
Cheers.
And we left the coronavirus behind.
We are about to go on the lake to Wet Piper.
on the island, and we could hear everybody in the background just hooping and hollering, and anyway, it was just, that was a fun
But
memory.
Everywhere we went on that trip to restaurants and stuff.
You planked. Yes, the elbows.
Over at Baytown War.
Rum Runners?
Rum Runners.
Yeah, Rum Runners.
And Dennis planked on the bar stools there while we were waiting on our table.
I just know that when y'all came home, it was like the radio was blaring. It was like Flo Rida, Get Low.
Yes.
And Roger and Slim Shady.
Yeah, I remember Slim Shady.
I think was that just, the house too that we played a lot of
Britney Spears?
Lady Gaga.
Love her.
That was at Rose Hall. Yes.
That's a good one. I like that one.
Yeah, because I had videos of that on my iPod Touch. I was like scared of everyone. Everyone was being so
So you
wild.
Called and told on us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. She was scared because they were acting weird.
They were just laying, planking. Yeah. All right, Ainsley's turn.
Okay. But I know everyone knows, like, the table situation. Yeah. But I'll just talk about it.
Say it in full definition.
This is at the Andalusia house, right? Yeah.
Didn't Roger get, like, Elmer's glue to try to fix it?
No. So, Will and Ryder were just... So bad. They were just coloring with like some markers, just being.
Yeah, we were making like bracelets too.
I was like bored, and I was like, "Oh, let me just go sit on this table." But it wasn't like a sit. Like I jumped. I jumped from like the bed to the table.
Oh.
And it was so bad because I remember the table went like this, and Will. I remember Will's face. He was like, and the markers. He was trying to get all the markers. And then, y'all two were like one of the only people home, like my mom, like mom and grandpa, and I felt so bad. And didn't I think that like y'all were probably at the store?
We were at the.
They were probably playing golf
at the store again.
Yeah.
And somebody asked for Elmer's glue.
We called
Jamie Collins. Said, y'all get some Elmer's glue, and we're like, what? Well, Ainsley broke the table, and we're like, and you want Elmer's glue?
And I remember I tried to pay Grandpa with all these coins I had brought.
He was mad.
It was like 80 cents or something. Like,
I just remember I was
so
just
mad.
Trying to make bracelets or something with that rainbow loom thing, and then just seeing. I just remember seeing Ainsley like backwards, like the backwards version of herself, just jump onto the table and then see it just like crash down and then everything just slide. And then Will was just like panicking, and then Ainsley was just like, oh my gosh. And then it was all just a blur. Like,
all blur.
That's a good one.
Kathy,
you got one?
You
recording?
Not really. But I really like like one of my favorite parts of the trip when we go is when we hula hoop. Last year, I thought it was really funny when we were hula hooping and Gran was doing it. She kept farting.
I remember that we were like one slipping out, another one slipped.
Lauren last year, she goes, Queensland was right next to them.
Yeah, me and Lauren were sitting right next to her.
We just be like, did another one slip? Like, is that another one?
Both farted.
Just wait until you get old. You will see what it's like.
Hey, Grandpa. Jack's watching you.
The standout memory of Andalusia. We had a lot of memories.
Yeah.
When we called the police, and the people that were breaking in the house across the street. And the lights went out in our house. And the police said they couldn't come because it was gated.
They couldn't get in the gate because the power was out.
Turns out the people were just moving into the house across the street.
Yeah. Using their flashlight to put their luggage up.
Because the power was out.
But we felt like they were robbers.
We thought they were
robbers. Just like we were all up late at night and it was...
Well, then we almost said it was burning up. We're like, why is it so hot?
Somebody came in and woke us up.
Jackie came in because it woke me up to sleep.
The lights are out.
There's something wrong. The power, I mean, it scared me to death. The power's gone out. I don't know what's caused the power. The power's gone out.
And then we realized it was the burglars across the street that had knocked the power out. so that the police couldn't get in and catch us.
The guy was running.
We knew it.
The
guy
was running. And that's how people get shot by the police.
Henry, yeah.
Okay, so my favorite memory, this was, it took me a minute to think about this one, but it's about me.
All right. Doing my backwards word.
So, it was at the Yellow House.
The Yellow House.
Do you remember that house?
Giant's Rest.
Giant's Rest.
Yeah. Whoa. And the Ainsley and Piper had that big pink room.
Mm-hmm.
And one night there, I was in their room sitting on the couch, and they were like, "Hey, what movie should we watch?" And I didn't want to seem too weird, but I was like, "Hey, maybe we should watch Sharpay's Marvelous Adventure."
Yes.
And we all had a good laugh.
I thought you were going to say that underwear was Sharpay.
She's from High School Musical.
He was sitting on the couch while we were asleep, just watching.
It's hard. It's so hard because there's so.
The lighting's kind of weird. I'm sorry.
It's weird, but I still my favorite night was the karaoke night. I just sit there and I think about like things like the skink night or when we found the skink in the bucket,
yes.
But. Because that karaoke night was just so random. Like, we just went, and I don't even know why. Like, I don't think we had any intention going to do that.
No.
But we'd never been there. And it was also the last night that those guys down at the Seaside Amphitheater thing, that was their last night to perform. So they were all there. And then it was just...
Wheels off.
Wheels off. Todd gets up and he's like karaoke king. Doing the man. And then all the guys are getting up and having the whole bar. It's like one of those movies where everyone's like singing and has their arms around each other. And then we did
John Deere Green.
Yes. Yeah. And then something was crawling across our feet underneath the table.
Shane and Amanda. Everyone was sitting up with their legs. And that was another thing too. Shane and Amanda were there.
They were there.
And but it was, oh gosh, that was, and it was just such a good vibe, and everyone was just, we had such a good time.
Yeah.
So that was probably one of my favorites.
Yeah.
No, but there were a bunch of memories, but right when, like, Todd, like, brought it up, it's just one came to my mind, and I laugh every time I think about it. It's probably no one knows about this. Uh-oh. I think Ainsley's the only one.
Oh, no!
No, it's not that. Oh, but I remember one time we went to, like, this arcade place. Like, one year was probably, like...
We went to Panama City Beach.
Probably. I think that might have been the time we did, like, go-karts.
Yes. Grandparents took the kids.
Yes. Or it was whenever it was, like, just us that year. Just the Sullivans, maybe. I don't remember. But
I think we were all there.
Yeah, but we were at an arcade. I just remember it being, like, where there's, like, that bar and there's all those, like, candy where you can pick out if you have enough tickets or whatever. So, I thought I saw Grandpa in this one of those arcades where you like sit down and it's like a like kind of like a bench and you like shoot or something like that, like one of those kind of things. I remember running over and being like, "Grandpa, Grandpa!" and like going to him, and this guy turns around and it's like a Mexican man, but he's bald and he's like big. I don't know why I thought it was Grandpa, and then he just stared at me and I got so scared, and I just remember being like, why did I think that was Grandpa? He was like bald and he had like rolls in the back of his head.
I thought you were gonna say when you got in the crash on the go-kart place, I felt so bad. I was crying.
They stuck.
The people were mean.
No,
to
yeah, they stuck me in. One was like on the back, and one was on the side.
He was just hit.
I'm gonna think.
I know. I'm thinking of the best. I mean, more just
I know that probably wasn't like the best one, but just one that came to mind.
When I first think about family trips with y'all, this family, I don't know what house it was, but it's when we had that big old that two-person bike.
Yeah, that was Sam and Claire.
That was,
yeah.
There are all those pictures.
We gotta be so dorky driving down the street in this thing.
But y'all couldn't wait.
Y'all, you're the one about to decide.
I know.
Yeah.
You
never watched y'all ride up on her.
Yeah.
Didn't we get that? One of them in San Diego, so that's what made us.
Yeah, probably so.
Yeah, you can see.
Not married that long.
We all had those pictures of us on the bike with Todd.
Yeah. And the night that we did the karaoke, because I was like, I actually can go out there and sing John Deere Green, because I don't know one person here. And when I go back home, that was a joke. And then all the golf, Chris, Casey, and I played.
Out here golf courses, that was a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. Remember that time y'all went to play golf in the rain? So that happened a lot. Yeah, it didn't matter. It's Florida. We didn't care. We're just getting out of here.
But I would say, you know, obviously the most recent, and you know, one of the things I think about looking back when I was a kid, I mean, the memories that we made this trip with all the kids having fun on the tube, like I had more fun watching them on the tube than I ever did doing it myself.
Yep.
And so it was it was fun to get to do that.
So your kids,
did it make
you
old pulling around kids, and you're the daddy pulling them around?
No, it just made me feel good.
Yeah.
Because we'll be able to do this a lot more, hopefully soon.
Yeah, it was great. Thank you, Todd.
Yes, thank you.
What?
Your turn.
I can't really think of anything.
If you can't think of anything,
Charlie, go ahead.
You will not be back if you don't have one good memory.
Charlie, what about Noel?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We went to see Noel. We saw Maddie's show.
And what was he? He was a magician. And he got the Merlin Award.
You're like trying to help him, like, remember.
You called you Stabby? And, I mean,
yeah, you were talking about that earlier.
When you jumped in the pool.
Go back to Crandall and tell people that you had seen the Merlin Award.
Yeah. What about when you and Todd had a bet when playing Wits and Wagers?
Todd, you jumped in the pool.
Yeah.
Because I lost in a game. I remember that. I didn't remember that until just now. I can't remember. Unless you're talking about it.
All right.
Or when we stay on Spooky Lane and you guys try to scare me. That's
Angie's a big thing.
Also, AC crashed her bike like 3 times.
In the bushes.
Yeah, like the same spot.
Last year. I don't get how somebody does that. Okay, tell me. Because you could see where the bush was bent over.
That was your spot.
It just kept going in that same spot.
All right, well.
So one of probably my most memorable memories was in, I think it was the Giants rest house, the yellow one. Was when me and Casey were flipping those.
All the videos are in slow mo. It's just.
I don't remember who won the challenge.
Yeah.
That was so awesome.
That's my favorite. Wow.
That's right.
The year of the bottle flip. You hit the year of the plank, the bottle flip. Every year has this little.
Candy Crush year. Oh my gosh.
That was the skate cast.
All right, Raj.
Oh, I just remember that time that.
Oh yeah.
Back when I was working, driving my truck.
We're talking about vacation. Oh my gosh.
When this truck stopped, got me a cup of coffee and hot dog free.
I delivered this one package.
Go ahead. Wait a minute.
This was like the Monday after we got back from vacation. I was getting ready for work. I didn't have a lot of time. Need to take a shower, grab some underwear, get in there. And as I'm getting ready and throwing on my underwear, I kind of look at them. These look weird. I've never seen these. But I was out. I didn't have time to think about it. Put the underwear on. Put my clothes on. Went and grabbed something to eat real quick. And took off to work. And then when I got to work, I had to change into my brown UPS pants, and as I took my jeans off, I again kind of looked at them. These look weird. I don't know.
Where have you been, Jackie?
So, I'm going down the highway after I get on the road. I'm driving to Shreveport, and I'm thinking about this and thinking about it, and I'm thinking, you know, Sandra was washing clothes, and Jackie was washing clothes on vacation.
Oh, yeah.
This must be...
Oh, I know.
Casey's underwear. It must be Casey's underwear. The more I thought about that,
this ew.
So, I didn't really communicate with him too much, but I had his phone number, but I sent him a text.
Who's him?
Casey.
You didn't communicate with my dad.
Yeah.
Casey.
You need another margarita?
Who's him?
Whale.
So I decided it must be Casey's underwear. Remember that? So I had his phone number and I sent him a text while I was driving. I sent a text and I said, I think I'm wearing your underwear. So I don't know what he's doing, but he gets a text and then he comes back in a minute or two and says, Who is that?
He's like, what in the world? Because I just got this text that says
he was at a bar.
Was he at a bar? Or
yes.
Well, then that, or he texted me or something, and he said I got the weirdest text, or he called me and said I just got a text saying
he was at a bar.
Okay.
At some function,
or maybe it was a work
function. I know he was with other guys. It might have been a work function.
Yeah. Yes. Or no, you know what? He might have been actually at Ride Org. Like their golf tournament thing?
Yeah.
Because...
I'm a dork.
I think so. Okay. I think that that's dork. What it was. Because I think he was like saying that he got this weird text. And then come to find out it was you.
Didn't he text you again? I can't remember how
well, no, I know what. Then you said back to him, he was like, who is this? And you told him who you were. And then you said... I can put them in your mailbox. And he texts back and said, no thanks.
He said something like
you can have them.
So there, after that was over, yeah. I had just started my night. I was just driving through the night there with Casey's underwear. I was thinking this is kind of like walk a mile in my shoes, but yeah. It's like going out in my underwear.
Yeah,
that's a good story.
Okay, Lindsay.
Okay, mine was the first vacation with the family, 2015, and it was the night that Chris, me, Jamie, and Casey went down to the beach, just us, to watch the meteor shower. Yeah. Remember that? Mm. And the sand was so cool, and it felt so great. And it was really cool. And the funny thing was that, I don't know if you remember this, Jamie, but we would all be looking, and us three would go, there's one! And every time, Jamie's like, where? Where? And it's like, you just kept, but I know, you saw plenty too. So that was a good one for me. I also just want to say, the volleyball, that is awesome every year. It's so memorable. And foosball. Now, with all the foosball competitions, the volleyball.
Now it'll be golden.
The actual ball, started in Mexico. Yeah. And love that we're doing that. And that's always so much fun. Yeah. So, good memories.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot to choose from. Golf is definitely up there. As far as all of us, I guess it would be the first year that Lindsay came when we had the little shock
guy. Oh, yeah.
My finger got numb. I did it so much. I kept doing it. My
I bought it somewhere.
Yeah,
I gave it to Jamie.
I think it was at Alice Beach.
Then the other one also that we were just kind of talking about, that's when we were just, I don't think it was all of us, but the Angie.
Yeah.
Mm.
We were talking about the haunted spirit that is always around us. And
the red solo cup.
Yeah, there was a solo cup with Angie written on it in the kids' room.
It was under the bed.
Yeah.
It said Angie on it, I guess. Yeah.
So, I guess it was one night we were all in the living room and we started talking about Angie.
That was the year that was just our favorite.
Yeah.
So I had gotten up and said I had to go to the restroom.
Yes, I remember this.
Snuck out the
so
back
much.
Door and got a sheet from off the bed, put it over my head, walked around to the front window, and just started banging on it. Jamie's scream was the loudest.
Well, heck,
that was. That traumatized me so much. No, I remember hiding behind the couch being so traumatized and then seeing it walk in, being like...
Well, what was really funny about it too was Ryder was just crying. Got into Saunders' lap. They were just...
Yeah. I think Ainsley hit the floor. I had jumped.
Piper was there and she was... Ryder was crying. Piper was grabbing his foot and saying, Angie.
Still such a pest.
She was egging
That's
it up.
Also Piper. I have memories from every single trip.
Oh,
every
gosh.
Single trip. Memories. I can hear things being said. But I think the one that sticks with me the most, and always will, and because I can look at it on a video, is when we were at the God's Rest. And we walked down to Rosemary Beach. And the ABBA band,
cover band
for ABBA.
Now listening to
was
it.
Playing. And
Dancing Queen.
Dancing Queen. Yes. And that song will never, ever play that I won't think about that night.
That was a fun night.
Yeah, I remember that.
That was so
fun.
Much fun.
We have that on video.
Yep. And showing
the fun that we were all having. Yeah.
We could probably go around.
Oh,
gosh. Two more times. Introduced us to her alter ego.
Yeah.
Teresa. Could you do a little bit of Teresa for us tonight?
That's right.
Well, it was a little bit weird because she was British, but she was from New York, so it was a little bit weird. But she would always come out and then she would say, oh, let me go get my friend Ainsley. She's in the other room. Sorry, I have like a wig. And
she
like,
had a black wig when she was Teresa. Oh, and then she would come back as Ainsley.
And then at the end of every night, I would every drop night. It on accident. And be like, oh, no. Like, unveil the act.
I remember sometimes I'd be like your sidekick. And I remember...
Yeah,
like,
and you were Felicity. That was your
name. Felicity.
It was an American girl all I wanted. Oh, I was named after my dance teacher.
It was
now, Lauren, do you have yours?
Yeah.
Well, zoom out.
I hate pressure.
Oh, well, only one who hasn't gone.
No pressure.
The
night we ate stupid stuff.
The night we ate stupid
stuff.
Many times as ever.
This is just awful that you can't.
I have no good
memories. You can't go. Sorry.
How long have you been here?
Your vacation.
I'm just thinking. I mean, I have lots of good memories.
You're hula hooping.
You didn't have anything.
I kind of
did. Given yours.
Oh, okay.
Somebody's gonna give me one.
You're hula hooping.
The games, the puzzles.
Oh, the puzzles. Yeah.
Yeah. We didn't do a puzzle this year.
I mean, hula hoop has already been mentioned.
Yeah.
She was the queen of the hula hoop.
Oh, yeah. And how this really ever started, a long time ago when it was just Mom, Dad, Sonner, Dennis, and me and Chris. That's kind of how Florida all
started. That was the very first
And that was Hurricane Katrina, right?
That must have been in 2004
or 5.
Dennis had just come through.
Yeah.
I think it was 2005.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah.
Who was on the
line? It was the summer before she graduated at UNT.
Yeah.
So it was 2005.
Yeah.
Gosh, y'all all went to UNT.
I could pretty much say that I was sitting down on that white sand at sunset.
Oh, yeah. Feels so good. Yeah. Remember when we did...
It doesn't get better than that. I
know. Remember when we did the ketchup leg thing?
Oh,
like the shark riding? Me and Henry did that.
I was still at the house and I was using the bathroom and you called me and told me to bring ketchup to the beach.
You were like,
wait, ketchup?
Yeah.
And you know the, when we did the bonfire that one night, that was pretty good.
Cool.
I love going crab hunting, like just at night with the flashlight.
Oh, yeah,
we used to do that all the time when it was like just us four.
Mm-hmm. And there was a year that Ryder was golfing.
Yeah.
What?
We were in the middle of the street.
We were
walking back. Was it
golden?
Golden.
Shade.
Oh, he couldn't walk. And he had to take his pants off.
Yes, I had to go around his bush and put a towel around so he could take his bathing suit off.
Well, it's weird. No, but the thing is,
get those sand lines and bite you because y'all would never
wash the
swimsuit. You'd just put it back on and that has a sand lice in it, and they would bite y'all.
No, but I remember we were in it was like the middle of the street, and I remember, because it was kind of like darker outside, I guess it was like later, like one of the sunset ones, but I remember her just wrapping the towel around me and just like looking around, and me having to take them off and put on like normal shorts, and it was just so weird.
You didn't put on any shorts.
Oh yeah, and I think it was that same year. I remember it just started. Because always at the beach you can see the storm clouds like coming, and I remember it was pouring down rain, and we were just running back to the house.
And I walked back with Dennis.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's running.
Yes.
And told Amanda that she had met her shorts. Amanda came out.
Oh.
No. Well. She really did.
Yeah, she did. But.
But then after that,
we faked
your
ass. That was the Santa Clara
house. Oh, and that was the same house that Jackie got stuck in an inner tube.
we were trying to push it down, and it went above your head.
Yes. Oh, my gosh.
Really?
Yes, I remember that. That's one of my earliest memories. No, but I just remember Dad throwing us. He would hold us, and I just remember, yes, his skin is, I was so convinced he was a Mexican. He's so dark, you and him, and I just remember him, like, his skin was, like, so hot, and he was, like, so dark, and I just remember him, like, flipping me, like, so much, like, and it would just be so
weird. He flipped me a bunch in the pool, too.
Yeah.
Wait, do you remember when we were taking the pictures, and Andy was sad because someone was eating Doritos? And Todd went over to them and asked if they could have one of the Doritos.
Oh, yeah.
Where was that?
Remember that? Because
we were taking the picture. We were taking our family picture.
Some random person
and
had
Andy
Doritos?
And Andy was crying because she wanted Doritos because those people had it.
Yeah.
And so you had to go over and ask them if you could have a Dorito for her.
Remember when we played tennis? Us? Oh, yeah. We played tennis that one year?
Yep.
Yeah, that was fun. Yeah.
I remember at Giant's Rest as walking back because we did the last day we were there was a rain day, and we went down late in the day, you know, and just sat down on the beach and was coming back. But I can remember that trip was when Andy was just first learning to walk because we came up that road, that little 2-block road before we turned to go down to our house, and you were letting her walk along there.
Yeah.
And now Jack's learning.
Yes.
So. Before I say it, so there's parts of this trip that I know everyone's like, rolls their eyes at, but everyone still likes it. And I can promise you that there's not many families that agree to do this every year.
Yeah.
So that's a testament to y'all.
Yeah.
And every, you know, it's always done right, and, you know, everyone has their little nitpicking things, but we all have fun.
Yes.
But I guess it was 2 years ago when... And this, actually, I'm going to say something about Casey, because me and him would text back, we'd talk in the morning, like, let's just hit the road. And we can't, because, you know.
Wow. We have wives.
And his kids, grandparents.
Not even wives, it's the grandmas.
I'm like, I want to hit the road, you know, get up and get going, get back, drink my coffee, and hit the road, and, you know, we're ready to go, and they're waking up in their pajamas. Drinking coffee.
We had been up until 4 a.m. packing all the stuff that y'all had no clue what it took to put this trip on.
Anyway, so 2 years ago when Billy came.
We talked about this on the way here.
And we're driving back and I'm like, oh, we're going to stop for a sit-down lunch. Yeah. And it was the slowest lunch ever.
Yes.
And I was like, okay, I'm going to start the truck. And then the waitress comes around and says, would any of y'all like dessert? And Billy said, yes.
Yes.
It was the size of a pie.
We've been waiting for him to eat the whole thing.
Oh, God.
We're going to be here another hour.
That's right.
That's funny.
Remember when we went to that, it was like last year, or no, 2 years ago, and we went to dinner, and there was that guy on the stage that was singing.
Oh, that was terrible. He gave me like a migraine.
Shut gullies.
On his phone, and it's like, because I remember all of us, like all the kids, we were so over it.
No, it was like the volume was like thousand.
And it's like, and he says we're all going insane, and he's like recording everyone, and it's like me and like my friend Lauren, we were like fighting, and then like Charlie,
Henry like hit Will.
Henry's like hitting Will. Chris is over here like trying to talk to Piper. We're all like,
well then I'll never forget. You went to the bathroom.
And there was a speaker playing.
Charlie said he had to go to the bathroom, and he said, I thought I was gonna get away from it.
I know.
I got in there, and there was a big speaker in the bathroom, and it was playing.
We could never escape.
And even down the road playing at the ice cream.
No, because you could so you could see
find out how much he was making the same that night. Yes. We would give him the same amount of money. If
he would stop, because he would never stop.
But you could see there was like a little like waiver thing that showed like when he was playing or something, and it was like, I was like, this is way past his time. I was like, he should be over now or something. And then he was like, I'm going to take a break. And it was like for 1 minute.
Yeah.
And then
yeah,
he just kept on going for us like at all. Well, and I will say too that, and even like what Todd said, you know, everybody's got their little, you know, get irritated every now and then or whatever. But, I mean, this was always Casey's favorite thing to do. Get together with family and go to Florida. And I'm sure he would have loved this too because He would have had
tons of stories. You know, so
he was
here. Probably ones we forgot.
Yeah. But that's why I love doing it, just because, you know, like Ryder said a minute ago, it's like it just seems like there's somebody missing. And I said, well, there is somebody missing.
Yeah.
Huge person that's missing. Yeah. But when we do this, I think it keeps his memory alive. Even though he's not physically here, he is here.
Yeah.
He's here. And
so like he said, yeah.
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 See?
And as time goes by, y'all look back, and we probably will be here, but
the memories
will be here.
Yeah.
Y'all will have to keep it going after we leave.
I think about that all the time, about how, like, you know, you three are going to have to get, like, keep this going. Yeah, so that, and, like, when we're older and have our families, we still need to go on trips and, like, I'm going to have to be the one to organize
you
it.
Will.
Well, I don't know how that's going to happen. I'm going to have to bring all y'all together.
I would be really good at helping, too, but I feel like if me and Ainsley would do it, we'd just get mad at each other and then just leave.
It'll be Ainsley, Piper, and Andy.
Oh, my gosh. Jack will be, like, grown up. We could look at this video and be like, this is us before, like, and, like, our kids will see, like,
our mother and daddy instilled the sense of family in us, so that even before all of y'all were born and came into the family, our siblings and us did things together all the time. And then as we've added, you know, the holidays still continue with siblings, but everybody's families have gotten larger. But that's why traditions are so important. And I think that you all have the same sense of family instilled in you that will make you want to continue these traditions.
Yes.
Now, because we have those funny stories
when we were growing up.
We have the same that y'all have heard us tell many times. Bill Fredericks. We weren't there, but we've heard the story over and over. And I think about when, you know, we would go to Galveston a lot as kids. And don't you remember that time Daddy got real sunburned in Galveston, and we were staying at the SS
Chevette. SS Chevette.
But, he was a bear that rest of that trip because he was so sunburned.
And as kids, me and Jackie and Billy, this is where Reggie Rodney was, you know, and we would go places, and
Jack,
the three of us, and we'd be in the back seat, and Billy would have to be the one driving the middle, us from fighting. But we would do this.
Well, I was the one in the middle when y'all were doing that.
Yeah.
You push my head back, we'd do this.
Push your head back?
No, like when Sandra's going to push, and then Billy would go like this.
That that's how we would entertain ourselves in the car.
Oh,
we,
my God.
We push in our hands.
However, can you wait?
Yeah.
Bye,
Jack.
Wait, Jack.
Your beer?
Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. I want more berries and that summer feeling. It's so wonderful and warm. Breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't know if I could ever go without. I'm just thinking out loud. I don't know if I could ever go without. Watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high, watermelon sugar high. Like a song, I want your belly and that summer feeling. I don't know if I could ever go without. Watermelon sugar high, 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 watermelon sugar high.
Challenge, all you gotta do is leave it better than you found it. It's gonna get difficult to stand but hold your balance. I just say whatever cause there is no way you're round it. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay, it's okay, it's okay. Walk around the neighborhood, feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. Hey, some days you wake up and nothing works, you feel surrounded. Gotta give your feet some gravity to get you grounded. Keep good things inside your ears just like the waves and sound it. And just say whatever cause there is no way you're grounded. Everyone falls down sometimes, but you just gotta know it'll all be fine. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I'm feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. I'm feeling good, like I should. When in dark, I walk around the neighborhood. Feeling blessed, never stressed. Got that sunshine on my Sunday best. She rattled the eyes in my plastic cup. I said yes, ma'am, fill her up. Tell me something good that I don't know. Cause this world's been kicking my behind. Life ain't been a friend of mine. Lately I've been feeling kinda low. And she looked back over her shoulder, pointed at the sign hanging up on the wall. Let's see, everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. And nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button.
Oh, hey, y'all.
You got the hackers?
Said that's for sure. Dropped a few bucks in the mason jar. Felt those good old neon vibes on me. And whatever monkey that was on my back, he jumped off just like that, right into the deep blue sea. And I look back over her shoulder, thinking about the sun hanging up on the wall. Let's say everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It ain't near as bad as you think. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything's gonna be alright. And nobody's gotta worry about nothing. Don't go hitting that panic button. It ain't near as bad as you think. Everything's gonna be
Roblox?
Isn't that a toy?
No, it's not a toy.
It is, I promise. That's a thing kids play. That's a game where kids play.
But that's like not a game.
Yes, it is. I'm sure it's a game.
So, when you lose a toy, how do you feel? That's how I feel.
catchphrase?
Yeah!
No.